Hello friends, this is Shashi Agarwal channel. I, Dr. Shashi Agarwal, welcome you all for the subject microeconomics, business economics. Our topic is today profit. We will understand what is the meaning of the profit, what is the meaning of the gross profit, what is the meaning of net profit, what are the elements of the gross profit and what are the elements of the net profit, and what is the difference between the gross profit and the net profit. In the second part, we will be focusing on the theories of the profits. It's written out, they will be available at my blog. First of all, we will understand what is the meaning of profit. There are four factors of production: land, labor, capital and entrepreneur. Land gets rent, labor gets wages, capital gets interest. It is the entrepreneur who gets the profit. Profit is a factor income which is available to the entrepreneur, because the entrepreneur set up the business, he takes the risk, he bears the uncertainty, and that is why he is getting the reward in the form of profit. The income which he get, that is called profit. Profit is a surplus income. That is the difference between the firm's total revenue, that is the total receipt, and the difference between total revenue and the total cost. If the total revenue is more than the total cost, then the entrepreneur is having profit. It is a positive residue. Just for the sake of example, there is a he is making furniture. Cost is 8,000. He sells it 10,000. So his total receipt is 10,000 and total cost is 8,000. So the difference is 2,000. If the total revenue is more than the total cost, then he is earning the profit. If the total cost is less than the total revenue, then he is incurring the suffering the loss. Profit is a reward for entrepreneurship services. Profit may be considered a reward for making innovation. It means he is introducing the new and useful things. He may be making a new product, he may be using a new process, he may be entering some new market. So he is introducing the innovations in his business, and it is also a reward for bearing the risk. And because the market is not perfect, there is market imperfections. How he is managing the risk, how he is managing the imperfection, and in that is why he is getting the reward in the form of profit. So profit is a reward for taking the entrepreneurship services, because he is setting up the business, he is introducing the innovation, he is bearing the risk, he is bearing the market imperfections. What are the concepts of the profit? Gross profit and net profit. What is the gross profit? That is equal to total revenue minus explicit cost. Explicit cost is the cost which is actually incurred on using other services and products. Explicit cost are out of the pocket cost which is paid in reality, which is incurred in actual term. So total revenue is 20,000. Total expenses paid in the form of rent, wages, interest is 10,000. So gross profit minus gross profit is equal to total revenue minus the explicit cost. 20,000 minus 10,000 is equal to gross profit. So what are the elements of the gross profit? Interest on entrepreneurship's own capital, wages of entrepreneurship's labor, rent on entrepreneur's land, depreciation charges, insurance charges, and the pure profit. Now we will understand what is the meaning of net profit. Net profit is equal to gross profit minus implicit cost. And what are the implicit cost? Explicit cost are the out of the pocket cost which are paid in actual terms. Implicit cost, which is not paid to anyone, this is the cost of self-supplied factors. Like entrepreneur, he is using his own building. Entrepreneur, he has introduced his own money in the business. So here we will be calculating the implicit cost of the self-supplied factor by the entrepreneur. We will be knowing the calculating the notional cost to know the true cost of production. So net profit is equal to gross profit minus implicit cost. So total revenue minus total cost is equal to explicit cost plus implicit cost. So here we are calculating the economic profit, which is the pure profit, which is the difference between the total revenue and the total cost, like rent on entrepreneur's own land, interest on own capital, wages on entrepreneur's own labor. So what are the elements of the pure profit, economic profit? Reward for taking the risk, because the entrepreneur is taking the risk, he's setting up his business and there is uncertainty whether his business will be viable or not. So there is a risk of market condition, there may be risk of intense competition, so he is managing the risk, he is taking the risk, that is the reward for taking the risk. The second is the reward for bearing the uncertainty, because entrepreneur gets profit because he is bearing uninsurable risk, because there are two types of risk, one risk which could be insured and there is a second risk which cannot be insured. So he is bearing uncertainty, that is why he is getting the reward. And reward for ability, when a entrepreneur, he is optimizing the use of the resources, he is having high ability, so he will make more profit. Monopoly gain, sometimes the entrepreneur happens to operate in a monopoly, so he could charge high price, there will be more demand, so he will be having more profit. And there may be some windfall gain, many times due to certain events demand may increase and he will be having much of the profit due to the sudden increase in the demand. And the reward for innovation, his entrepreneur introduce any innovation in the business, that may be in the form of some new process which reduces the cost, it may be introducing a unique product, a useful product, so he will be charging more price, so he will be because due to the introduction of the innovation he is having more profit. So what is the difference between the gross profit and the net profit? Gross profit is a wider term because it includes the net profit, but net profit is a narrow term. Gross profit, because gross profit minus explicit cost, and gross profit includes implicit cost, but net profit is the gross profit minus the implicit cost. It is not possible to know the from the gross profit, we will not be possible to know the real profit or real loss, but from the net profit, because we will understand the total revenue is total revenue is more than total cost, then we are having profit. If the total revenue is less than total cost, then we are incurring the loss. Net profit is not earned under the perfect competition, because here the entrepreneur is earning only normal profit, which is a part of the cost of production. Net profit is not earned under certain condition in the long run, so only a part of the gross profit, that is the normal profit, is obtained. Now the question arises, the payment which is made for the use of the services of the entrepreneur is called the profit. Profit is a factor price which is paid to the entrepreneur and it is a positive residue. Reward given to the factors of production, like the labor is wages, capital is interest, rent is paid to the land, and that is the wages, interest and rate, they are included in the price of the commodity. Is profit a part of the price? Normal profit, the minimum amount which is necessary to keep the entrepreneur in a given business, is called normal profit, and normal profit is a part of the cost of production. So normal profit influences the cost. Super normal profit, it does not enter into the price because it is not included the price. So normal profit jo hai, that is a part of the price.